First of all, smart cities are going to be more important in the near future. Within 10 years, 2 out of 3 people will be living in urban areas, and many of them in big cities. And the importance of light in big cities is that they bring safety, but they also bring well-being, they bring attractiveness to cities. And with the Internet of Things and all this innovation in digital lighting, we're going to bring much more functionality into lighting systems that can play a role in making the cities more livable, more safe, more enjoyable, but also more economically sustainable. You will see much more dedicated applications of lighting. So today you could say we bring illumination. We want to go beyond illumination and have lighting that is much more geared, for instance, to bad weather conditions, but also events. If we have lots of football fans visiting a city, how can we guide them safely through the city? And in case of emergency, how can we actually secure that they have a way out? What's very important for smart city lighting is, because the opportunities are endless, that we start experimenting with the citizens themselves. So rather than having a laboratory where we do the work, we want to move the laboratory actually to the city and work together with the city government, with industry, other industry, and with the citizens. So very much we have to experiment and find out what are the good use cases, what is the good usage of lighting in modern cities. Yeah, if we can provide a platform, which means that there's an infrastructure where people can experiment on, then we can also offer individual citizens or group of citizens or one street the access to the data and develop with them interactive use cases for lighting, which could be how to light your street for a party, yeah? Or how to make your street more safe, or bring a feeling of comfort and safety by tuning the lighting colors and involving the citizens in these new use cases. But having the platform is extremely important to be able to do these co-creation experiments with citizens. So apart from the energy saving that intelligent lighting systems will bring, I think they will also see a lot reduced maintenance cost. So the future of intelligent lighting systems is that they will self-diagnose and tell the city management which kind of maintenance they need. So there is new functionality that connected lighting systems can bring. And you can imagine that we can integrate sensing networks in the lighting infrastructure that can tell you about the air quality. Actually, this is very relevant for big cities. And you can use the mesh network of lighting to tell you what the air condition is in the various parts of the city. Another thing is that intelligent lighting networks can negotiate with power supply to balance the demand and the supply of power. So that gives a much more efficient energy uses in the city. Also connectivity can bring tracing cars, traffic management, but also your stolen bike in the city. And you can actually interact with the people and tell them where their stolen bike is in the city and have a mobile app that connects to the lighting infrastructure. It's very important that we engage in an open innovation ecosystem which has the citizens, the city management, other companies working together. And I think the relevance of this conference is that it brings together these stakeholders to talk about the opportunities of lighting, the needs of the citizens, and also actually make a plan for the future to see how we can start these large-scale experiments.